Let's go into the night with Rick Ballew on 1010 XL 92.5 FM.
The howling wind! My goodness! It'll make babies out of the meanest men, I tell you. And that's what's going on at Augusta. A lot of complaining. Terrible body language, facial expressions. And only one golfer so far who has completed a round in the 60s. Who would have thought that after what we witnessed on Thursday? Ludvig Åberg, a 69. He is at 2 under par. He is tied for 7th. Scotty Scheffler has moved ahead. He still has 5 holes remaining. He is out on the golf course, -1 today after a 66 yesterday. He has a 1-stroke lead over both Max Homa and Bryson DeChambeau. Those 2 rounds are complete. Great to have you with us. Second round coverage continues from Augusta and the first major during the calendar year. I'd love to say that typically one of my favorite things to witness is members of the PGA Tour crying on a golf course, but I can no longer say that, right? Because there are 13 members of the LIV Tour also battling their way in and around Augusta, and that includes a defending champion, John Rahm, who's looked just awful today. I mean, I think he's, what, +3, +4? I'll give you the very latest here momentarily, but, I mean, again, his disposition, his aggravation, wearing everything out on his sleeve, and I love it. I do. I don't want to see this on a week-to-week basis. As I've said forever, I wish it was more difficult here at the Players' Championship. It feels like, you know, the rough with the United States Open. You never really know about the weather with the British Open. You could throw in the PGA Championship. We just see the greatest players in the world go low, low, low. And they try to tiger-proof it, right? They're always adding distance off the tee, all the changes that they make. I do eventually agree, and I think most golf fans out there would feel the exact same way, that, you know, sooner or later, they're going to have to make some changes with the equipment. They're going to have to roll back the golf ball. That only makes, you know, it makes perfect sense. There's really no other way to talk about it. And, you know, that was discussed a little bit earlier this week with the current commissioner out at Augusta, you know, with the Masters, about, in fact, doing exactly that, finding a way to change things, because they've tried to do everything else with the golf course. And you want to have 8,000-plus yard golf courses. I mean, this year's Masters is playing at 7,550 yards. And it is the wind which has been the major factor so far today. So it's great to have you with us, along with J.J. LaSalva. My name is Rick Ballew. Tons of Masters coverage here over the next couple of hours. Again, the low score today, Ludvig Åberg with a 69. Bryson DeChambeau has had a historic round. And, you know, I watched Tiger all morning into the afternoon, watched his completion of his first round. For those of you who were unaware, Tiger had at 1 under through Amen Corner, right? He played 13 holes late yesterday and had it at -1. Got up this morning, immediately bogeyed 14, had pars on 15, 16, and 17, and then had a bogey on 18 to shoot a +173. We'll take you through his second round momentarily, but it was certainly a lot of fun to watch. I mean, just incredible scrambling today by Tiger Woods, and it felt like on every hole he had to make somewhere between, let's say, a 6 to 8 foot putt in most scenarios to save par. A few of those were for birdies. As a matter of fact, his first 9 holes today, Tiger had 3 birdies, 3 bogeys, 3 pars. Pars were rare. He did get 7 coming in. 7 of his final 9 holes were pars with a birdie and a bogey mix. So it was an even round of 72 today for Tiger. And He is going to be around for the weekend, and of course, now it registers with a 24th consecutive cut made at the Masters, breaks the record that he was tied with both Gary Player and Fred Couples, but it was a lot of fun to watch Tiger's round. I mean, basically playing on one leg, broken down body, massive heart, but he was driving the ball well, and his short game was really good today. I think he made mistakes with short irons, mid irons. All right, short irons, obviously, I just talked about his short game. Around the green, he did well, but felt like he made a couple of errors trying to read, in fact, where the pin placements were today. A couple of par threes. He actually was very fortunate and got some good kicks, got some nice bounces. But off the tee, he was absolutely about as good as you could have asked for. So I imagine Tiger's very excited about that. Overall, pretty good effort, and we'll see how he holds up over the weekend. But I do want to get back to Bryson DeChambeau. Because, you know, of course, he with a 6-under or a 7-under 65 yesterday, he was in control of this golf tournament. And it just was a helter-skelter type of round. To say that it wasn't entertaining would be anything but a lie. And I know that there are some out there who really do believe that this sport is boring. And, you know, I've never really been able to subscribe to that theory. Then again, I never thought that baseball was boring, even when it would take 30, 35, 40 seconds in between pitches. If you're really invested in the game and you're really invested in the sport, it takes a little bit of time. But just to see DeChambeau, I think he called on at least three different times today for a rule official to help him with his ball, which obviously missed fairways. There was one point on 13 where he literally, and wait till you see the photo, if you haven't yet, he picked up a huge, it almost looked like he was carrying a massive size cross, right? You had three or four different, like, street signs telling you where to go. I guess this particular hole, that particular hole, maybe the restroom, I don't know. He picked it up out of the ground because it was in where he was trying to relieve, you know, and take his next shot from the pine straw. And not only did he move it, he replaced it after putting it on the green and then ended up making a birdie putt on number 13, which is the par five, you know, which is a par five hole, number 13. But it was during a roll in which he had gone bogey, birdie, birdie, bogey, and then he bogeyed 18 as well. So it was a little bit of a Phil Mickelson type of round for Bryson DeChambeau today. And again, he's put himself in really good shape with the 73 this afternoon plus one. He's only one stroke right now behind Scottie Scheffler, who, of course, is still out on the golf course. JJ, did you get to see the move of Bryson DeChambeau when he moved?
I did.
What looked like a mammoth-sized cross to me.
Can we get somebody to help the guy? Please? I mean, why do they have to do it themselves? Jeez, I feel like there's enough people working at the Masters. I know at the Players they would have handled that themselves. All the volunteers here would have done it for them. But yeah, the photo's absolutely hilarious. It's one of those like four-way stops. Like one of them's pointing to the concession, one's to like Amen Corner. It's hilarious.
I bet it weighed 150 pounds.
It's solid. It was just like old wood. It looked like
right. You know, waterlogged.
Yeah,
and what have
exactly.
You.
Rain all morning.
And he replaced it after.
Oh, did he? I didn't see that. What a good guy.
Yeah.
And they probably would have kicked him off the course for that. We did see some bad language.
Oh, yeah.
On the course today. Yesterday it was from Tyrrell Hatton, which not a surprise. Today we had Zach Johnson after a double bogey getting sort of like a sarcastic applause from the patrons. And he gave him the old, you know, he told him how he thought. Let's
and he's
just
been,
say that.
He's been getting, you know, I've interviewed Zach Johnson a few times over the years, and he's actually been here to Jaguar games. When I was a sideline reporter, I met him a couple of different occasions. Pregame on the sideline. I always really liked Zach Johnson. Now, obviously, he was criticized for his selection selections during the Ryder Cup.
Exactly.
But remember him going crazy a few weeks ago? Actually, it's been more than a few weeks ago now. It was back during the Phoenix Open.
Yeah.
And, of course, that's a fraternity type of audience and crowd there. But he screamed at them then. And then today, the exact same thing after, I think it was a triple bogey. Was it a double?
Yeah,
or triple?
Maybe it was a triple. Yeah, in Phoenix, I think he like got right in the face of a guy. A lot of frustration out on the course today. I mean, Spieth this morning, wow. First of all, he was absent. By the way, Scheffler's got a huge parpa coming up here on 13. But you saw Spieth this morning absolutely melt down. He was trying to throw his clubs every other hole. Like, the wind has these guys struggling out there today, man. Like, I think -3 is the highest score in the clubhouse all day.
You mentioned, yes.
And that was early, early.
Yeah, and that was by Oberg earlier today with the 69, the only golfer so far to have a round in the 60s. You mentioned Tyrell Hatton yesterday. Well, apparently he spit on the 12th tee earlier today, went absolutely crazy about that. Then on 16, he was furious as well, screamed at the ball, picked it up, and fired it into the water there on the par 3 16th hole. So I love it.
It's like the U.S. Open.
I love it. I love – because, you know, we're told all of these golden rules about this sport. Right, that, you know, oh, it's only a gentleman's sport. Yet, I don't know how I get it, but things that pop up on social media, for me, I get, like, all these golf fights that keep popping up on Twitter. And I'm like, how am I a part of this? I didn't subscribe to it. I don't follow any of these type of sites, but you know what it's like when you play golf around here. It's pretty difficult to go around without someone driving into you or giving you the eye that you're not playing fast enough, with them probably not even understanding that the reason why you're not playing fast enough is because the group in front of you is not playing fast enough. But still, we've always been told that golf is the gentleman's sport and it's a one of tremendous sportsmanship, yet you can really feel the angst when you're out there yourself playing, and certainly because of the wind today, which reached gusts up to 40 miles per hour. Incredible aggravation. And Scottie Scheffler just missed that par putt on the par 5 13th hole. So he is going to lose a stroke. He will drop now to 6 under. So we have a 3-way tie, two of which are in the clubhouse. That is Max Homa with a 71 today, Bryson DeChambeau again with the plus 173, and now with, let's call it 14, 15, 5 holes to go, Scottie Scheffler is on the golf course at 6 under par. So much more to do with that. You talked about why patrons didn't help out Bryson DeChambeau to actually move that huge,
not patrons, but more like, you know, people that work at Augusta.
Are you old enough to remember when Tiger got fans to move that huge boulder?
No, I
gotta
look that up right now.
Yeah, I mean, that's probably 25 years ago, or maybe even, you know, longer than that. And I believe it was out at the Phoenix Open. I may be incorrect, but I mean, I'm dating myself here.
Yeah, it was 1999.
Yeah.
Moving the rock.
Right. I mean, he just got a couple of guys to put down their beers, come out onto the golf course, and literally move a boulder for him.
Here, Tiger said many years later that they moved it the wrong way, but he didn't want to tell them to move it again, so he took his shot more to the right than he wanted to. I love that.
Not surprised at all. Hey, the early round yesterday, 72.6 was the average. The completion of the first round, which included this morning for many golfers, 74.2. So nearly a 2-stroke difference between the early draw on Thursday and the late draw on Thursday. The last time I saw this officially was just after 3 o'clock. So that was more than 3 hours ago. But so far today, the round, 75.77. That is today's round. And again, I don't have an updated time. Hopefully we'll get that upon completion of the second round at the Masters. There's still a lot of golf to go. Several golfers still out on the course. And right now, presently speaking, the projected cut line is +5. We have, let's see now, 52 golfers at plus five or better. And we're going to go through the leaderboard here momentarily. But just let me mention a few golfers who have won the green jacket and other, you know, individuals with really big names who are already on their way out of here. Okay. How about Dustin Johnson? I mean, Dustin Johnson is a birdie machine. He had one birdie in 36 holes at this year's Masters. He ended up shooting plus 13, 13 over par, man, a 78 and a 79 for Dustin Johnson. The Gary Woodland story is a very dramatic one. Maybe you saw the piece on him this Sunday morning on SportsCenter. I'm really good friends with a buddy of mine, Jacob, who is the first cousin of Gary Woodland, and it's a feel-good story. He had all his kids with him during the par three competition on Wednesday. Actually did have an ace on that day. Shot an 81 today, plus 13 for Gary Woodland, who, of course, has won a major. Some older golfers who won the green jacket. Of course, the way things work at Augusta, you're allowed to come back and play until you just feel as though you can't do it any longer. Freddie Couples plus 12 today. Charles Schwartzel plus 11. I shouldn't say plus 12 today. Through two rounds for Couples. Plus 11 for Charles Schwartzel through a couple of rounds. Bubba Watson shot an 80 today. Plus 10 overall. He's going home for the weekend. JJ mentioned Jordan Spieth, who's been battling a wrist injury. And it was obvious today. You could tell it was bothering him. He was wincing at times. But, man, he had a real difficult time measuring distance today. And again, the wind was brutal, but Jordan was so short on so many approaches. And then at times he, you know, extended the ball way past the pin, and Brooks Koepka was doing that all day. Even though Bryson DeChambeau was only one stroke over par, felt like he was doing that often today. Rory McIlroy missed a lot as far as his approach a little bit earlier yesterday, and as well as he continues his round right here on this Friday. Anyway, a plus 10 for Bubba. A couple of other notables, Jordan Spieth, I just said, a plus 9. Sam Burns, plus 9. Brian Harman, who I saw right before the Players' Championship here, instead of being over at Bay Hill, he was here with, you know, he had his trophy. He had the British Open trophy, and it was very, very, very cool to actually go up and be able to take a look at that. But the left-hander really has struggled. You know, an 81 yesterday after he completed his round. Today, he shot an even par 72, but not nearly good enough. A plus 9 for him, so he's not going to be around for the weekend. Also, formerly winning the green jacket, Sergio Garcia, a 79 today. He's going home. Justin Rose, a 78 today, plus 7, going home. Another left-hander, Mike Weir, who, of course, won at Augusta, I'm guessing what, some 20 years or so ago. A 77 today, plus 7. He's going home. We talked about Zach Johnson, a former winner of the Masters. A 75 today, plus 7 overall. He's going home. How about this? Two golfers right now who need at least one birdie coming in. Ricky Fowler and Victor Hovland. Okay, plus 2 today for Ricky. He's got 3 holes remaining. He's one stroke above the cut line at plus 6. Also, Victor Hovland, man, plus 7 today after a 71 yesterday. He shot a 1 under 71 on Thursday. He's plus 7 today through 12. Plus 6 for the tournament. So he's got 6 holes to pick up at least one stroke to be around for moving day and the weekend. We'll continue to keep you updated. Depending on how sensitive you may be, it's 30 years and 25 years, respectively, since Jose Maria Olazabal won the Masters. He did it 5 years apart. He's one stroke away at plus 6, but he's now in with a 73. Looks like he is not going to be able to make it I want to say he's 53 years of age, one stroke out at plus six. Adam Scott as well won a major, or excuse me, won the Masters. He's not going to be around as well with a plus six as well. Whatever happened to Hideki Matsuyama? He must have Hideki's actually playing better golf today. He was plus four yesterday. He's even today, so he's right above that cut line at plus four right now with, four holes remaining for Matsuyama. So, again, 52 golfers right now are projected to be around for the weekend. They are plus five or better. Just to remind you of the rules, they changed in 2020, and it's top 50 plus ties. Years ago, it used to be top 44, and then it was the 10-shot rule. If you were within 10 shots of the leader, you would, in fact, be around. So the way I'm looking at things, 10 shots, we would actually have gained one. Those would plus six would have been able to make it if things do stay the way that they are. You know, Homa and DeChambeau are in with six under. Scottie Scheffler still has five holes remaining. He is currently out on the golf course at minus six as well.
And a huge name just doubled to go to six over. The defending champ, John Rahm, six over par, zero birdies today.
Who picked him?
I don't know. Whoever didn't pick Scheffler.
I picked him.
Yeah.
No. You picked Rahm.
I probably, yeah.
Yeah, you picked Scheffler and I picked Brooks.
Oh, yeah. Then you picked Brooks before Rahm. Smart.
Right.
Then I guess. I don't know. Where is Brooks?
But Brooks is, last I think he was like plus three.
Okay.
But he's plus two.
Okay.
Consecutive 73s for Brooks Koepka.
Not bad.
But you had Scheffler and I had Brooks. Then you took Rahm and I took Hideki. So that means combined, I'm plus six of my two golfers. You took Shoffley and I took Cameron Smith. And then our long shots, you took Tom Kim and I took Patrick Reed.
Reed did great today. Reed was like two under. He's back to even, which I think is good enough for like top 15 at this point.
Mm-hmm. Let me see if I can find Cameron Smith before we head to
Cameron Smith is two under.
First break. All right, good. I finally have a guy in red figures.
He's had a low-key pretty decent day today. I think he's right about even. He finished with like a 36 on the front nine.
Yep. He shot a 70 today.
Yeah. Oh, he's still out there, Cameron Smith.
Oh, I thought you were talking about Patrick Reed.
No.
My bad. There are only 16 golfers in red figures. And let's see, 2, 4, 6, 7 of those are at one under.
Yeah. Morikawa was two under today. He's all the way up to fifth. They showed like one of his shots today. I didn't see anything from Morikawa. I also didn't hear anyone taking him coming into the tournament. Like,
yeah,
he's been like really struggling lately. So this is big for him. He's just three under. He's only three back from the lead.
All right, let me give you the front page. Homa, DeChambeau, and Scheffler at six under. Again, Scheffler on the course, five holes to go. Two strokes behind is Colin Morikawa is at three under par, as you just pointed out. Two strokes behind is Nico Højgaard, okay? A four under after a 67 yesterday, a plus 173 today, but he is at minus four. Three unders, Cameron Davis, Colin Morikawa. Ludvig Åberg with a 69 today. Again, that is the best overall round. He is at minus two. And that is, JJ just told you, Cameron Smith, he's only played 12 holes. He's at one under today, two under through the tournament. Matt Fitzpatrick is minus two as well with five holes remaining. And then at one under par, let's see, all of these golfers have completed their round except for Sepp Straka, who has one hole to play. He is at one under. But Tommy Fleetwood, Matthew Pavon, Cameron Young, B.H. On, Ryan Fox, and Danny Willett, a former Masters champion, all are at one under. As a matter of fact, I watched Willett a moment ago. He had a triple bogey on 18. Okay? He had it at four under, but gave three back on the 18th and final hole. He posted a seven. So, again, he is with a bunch of golfers at 1 under par, and we will continuously keep you updated as to what is going on. Second round coverage of the Masters. I love it. I love seeing these guys grind.
Especially after yesterday, I was worried. You know, like guys shooting that low, I'm like, is this going to be like a 20 under winner or something? You know, like are these guys going to just destroy the course? But no, they really, really did great with the hole placement today, pin placement, and just that wind is outrageous out there. It's affecting the putting. You know, as someone who doesn't really play at all, you just think, oh, the wind's affecting, you know, the drives and everything else, the iron play. But, man, it's killing these guys on the greens today.
Well, did you see what happened to Tiger, Homa, and Jason Day as they were trying to line up and putt on 18? You literally had, tons of sand flying out of the greenside bunkers, you know, into their eyes, which gets us to Shmunez vision.
Nice.
Okay, because if you were wearing contacts out there today, good luck. And when you're going out to play your golf, this just in, there's a lot of wind in Duval, particularly when it rolls off the, the Atlantic, or depending on where you're playing. Laser eye surgery, well, you could prevent that problem for the rest of your life. The good folks at Shmunez Vision, again, if you're struggling to see the golf ball, or you're just struggling time and again on seeing, it's time to finally step up and grab my advice. Check them out online. Go to Shmunez Vision. Again, everything is explained to you. Sure, you can get an update for your contacts and for your glasses, right? Yeah, but what about so much more than that? What if there is a serious issue? What if you're really concerned? You think you got a problem with a cataract, or you think it could be even more significant, more dangerous than that. That's why you want to visit people I've known forever, doctors that I've known forever. And it's a family organization that focuses on personal, high-quality medical and surgical eye care. Let me raise my hand right now, because Dr. Neil Shmunez performed surgery on my right eye 8.5 years ago, okay? Never been a setback, never been an issue. I have to wear contacts, unfortunately, because of that surgery. I'm not a candidate for laser eye surgery. If so, I would have had it done a long time ago. You could be. Check it out online. Go to Shmunez Vision. Care you can see. That is Shmunez Vision. All right, we are jam-packed. I love it. I love Fridays like this. No place I'd rather be right now than Hogan Road, okay? This is what it's all about. The second round of the Masters continues. Along with J.J. LaSalva, my name is Rick Ballew. We will keep you updated.
Now, a Masters update on 1010XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. The number one player in the world and the solo leader making an aggressive play at the par 5 13th.
Scottie Scheffler is in range to reach this green if he so chooses. The wind has died down slightly. You can't really feel it here on the 13th fairway. It's very protected by the tall pines. Based on where he's setting up, I think he's going to give this a crack at the green. A couple of waggles, feet settling in, club head down behind the ball. It appears to be his driving iron. Backswing, strike, and he is headed this right at the green, looking like it could be pretty good distance if it gets there. Oh, and it's going to catch the right bank and not get as fortunate as he did yesterday and go down on into the tributary at Rays Creek.
Johnson Wagner, the call on SiriusXM. The quickest way to go from having fun to having unfun in Amen Corner is finding Rays Creek. Scheffler could not save his par. A tap-in bogey there, so it's a three-way tie for the lead now. It's 6 under. Scheffler, along with Max Homa and Bryson DeChambeau. Homa and DeChambeau in the clubhouse at 6 under par. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
I am Robert Strickler. My wife Joyce and I have been married for 53 years. Certainly one of the really important things in my life are our children and our grandchildren. I am essentially a writer. I've been involved in communications in the media. I've been an avid fly fisherman for at least 40 or more years. I've been taking Prevagen on a regular basis for at least 8 years. For me, the greatest benefit over the years has been that Prevagen seems to help me recall things and also think more clearly, have a crisper ability to remember and think through things. And I enthusiastically recommend Prevagen. It has helped me an awful lot.
Prevagen, healthier brain, better life. Robert Strickler is a content contributor for Prevagen and real user, based on a clinical study of subgroups of individuals who are cognitively normal or mildly impaired. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Average score today in the second round is close to 75 with the wind ripping through Augusta National. Tiger Woods shot even par 72 to make the cut for a Masters record 24th consecutive time. He's plus one, seven back. Let's check the leaderboard sponsored by Prevagen. Prevagen is the most recommended memory support brand by pharmacists. It's Max Homa, Bryson DeChambeau, and Scottie Scheffler at 6 under par. Nikolai Højgaard at 4 under. Cameron Davis and Colin Morikawa minus three, three back. Morikawa, the two-time major champion, thrusting himself into the conversation with a 2 under 70 today. Ludvig Åberg with the only round in the 60s today, a 3 under 69. He's 2 under, four back. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emmerich, Westwood One Sports.
Discover luxury on your terms at Randy Marion Cadillac in Jacksonville and drive away today in style.
Boasting North Florida's largest selection of Cadillacs, we have your dream car waiting.
Immerse yourself in the unparalleled power and the elegance of the all-new Cadillac Escalade V.
Or experience the future with the Cadillac Lyriq, redefining luxury electric vehicles.
Thanks to our exclusive offers, the luxury of the Cadillac is more obtainable than ever.
And rest assured, every Cadillac is backed by our dedication to outstanding customer service.
Randy Marion Cadillac, Southside Boulevard, Jacksonville. Tell them Jennifer sent ya.
Hey, it's Matt Hayes. Spring is here, and that means your to-do list just got longer. But don't stress, everyone. The good folks at Fenwick Home Services have you covered 24/7 with cooling and plumbing solutions to fit any budget. From minor upgrades to major repairs, whatever problem you're staring down, the pros at Fenwick get it done and get it done right the first time. Spring is also a great time to schedule your AC tune-up to avoid costly breakdowns. Fenwick certified technicians will inspect your system to make sure it runs efficiently and remove buildup and dust, pollen and dander so you can breathe easier. Book now at fenwickhomeservices.com/radio.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Hey, sports fans, it's Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. Oh, it is here. Masters Week, my favorite. Tigers in the field. We've got the LIV Golf guys playing in a major again. It is going to be a blast. If you haven't signed up for MyBookie, you need to sign up. This is going to be must-see TV, and you can bet long odds for big golf sweats and even bigger cash. Outright winners, first-round leaders, and live betting too. I'm telling you, if you haven't signed up yet for MyBookie, do it now for Masters Week. Could the weather in Augusta cause some chaos? Take advantage of that. Make some money. Even if the Masters has started, you can live bet with long odds through Sunday afternoon. Getting started is simple. Sign up today at MyBookie and use promo code 1010XL to secure a first deposit bonus up to 50%. It's simple. Just use promo code 1010XL to claim your 50% bonus, $50 minimum. Bet anything, anytime, anywhere with MyBookie.
Certainly facing challenging economic times, I can't speak for all of us, but for me, comforting to know my money is in good hands with ITP Partners. Ticket here for ITP Partners, Jacksonville guys, taking care of my Jacksonville money. I'll admit it, I don't understand a ton about the economy, higher interest rates, 401ks. What I do know as I move closer to retirement, I continue to watch my money grow. Thanks to Chris Bryan, Jeff Hartman, Reagan Wright, Dan Abel, and Reed Wingate. Get in the game, guys. ITP Partners, always there to help. For more info, Chris at ITPPartners.com or call 904-312-9751.
Quarterbacking can be complicated. Denny Thompson simplifies it for us.
Yeah, I want to tell you what's really happening at the quarterback position.
Friday mornings on The Drill, brought to you by Tyson Sound and Security and George Moore Chevrolet on 1010XL.
Mark Watson with Hardball Creative, with the answers to the questions I'm asked the most. Yes, we are local, and no, I'm not hiring an actor to read these commercials. Check us out at HardballCreative.com.
Hardball Creative. Hardball does it all.
If you owe the IRS and can't pay, now is the time to call J. David Tax Law. After a two-year hiatus, the IRS has resumed their aggressive collections letters. Don't wait. Call J. David Tax Law or visit jdavidtaxlaw.com.
What is North America's largest freshwater fish? The answer coming up.
How long has it been since you compared homeowners' insurance rates? Log on to southernoak.com to find an agent or get an instant quote online. Find us at southernoak.com.
Our family protecting yours, Southern Oak Insurance.
North America's largest freshwater fish is the sturgeon, which this time of year you'll find swimming around in the Great Lakes.
Southern Oak Insurance. Our family protecting yours.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got two great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability. You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see them in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
Hey, I'm Tony from Tony D's Pizza. People ask me all day long, is it the water that makes the difference? Well, yes and no. Even water can make a good pizza. It's the ingredients, too. The best tomatoes, the best flour, and the best cheese. Oh, and a lot of love. Tony D's New York Pizza, Bay Meadows and 295.
Frank Frangie here. I was born and raised in Jacksonville, and I love living here. But I also know how bad bugs are in Florida. So I trust Orange Environmental Services to handle all my pest control needs because they've got the best technicians and effective treatment. Their name may be Orange, but they think green. Orange Environmental has been serving the First Coast for over 50 years, and they now offer complete lawn maintenance services. Call Orange Environmental Services for peace of mind from bug problems today. Call them at 272-3284. That's 272-3284.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Into the Night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Happy 70th to Pat Travers. Yeah, I think the Masters, along with snorting whiskey and drinking cocaine, fits perfectly. Especially if you're a DJ, right?
I was about to say, he's about to be off for the next couple days, so...
Oh, he fell down a flight of stairs. Plus 13 to 79 today, 78 yesterday. It's tough to believe. 36 holes. Only one birdie for Dustin Johnson. Somehow, though, he's got 300 plus million stashed away. Bad habits and all. You would think he's still going to have some cake. Man, I haven't heard of Pat Travers in forever. What has he done? I think he... He also covered the boom, boom, out go the lights, right? Years and years ago. But he's a Canadian rocker, considered one of the early, really good guitar players back in his day. But I don't know. Kind of a, he had his own little cult following. But he's 70 today. You know, kind of resonated growing up in Boston. Never heard a lot of him down here when I was in college and post-college. Yeah, I wasn't really rocking with the co-eds out in Tallahassee in the late 80s, early 90s, and I haven't heard it here in Duval all that much. But you'll hear those two songs on classic rock. Those are probably the only two you're going to hear. And I know we have some deep dive and deep cut Pat Travers fans who may get angry with me and tell me to listen to some other songs. And I may. Just go ahead and submit those to us on the text line 641-1010, brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures. Right now, cut line is plus five. We have unofficially 53 golfers who are at plus five or better. You know what happened today that we don't see often? A rattled Scottie Scheffler. Okay, now he came out, missed the putt on one, birdied number two. Then he missed somewhere in the neighborhood a 2.5, 3, 3.5 foot putt on number five. Okay, and I will admit it was about a 75-minute window today where I wasn't actually watching ESPN Plus or on the Masters app. I took a walk, so I was listening to PGA Tour radio or Masters radio, and the way it was described was that, you know, it's a tap-in putt to say party missed it. But after that, he was way left on the par 3 sixth, way right on the par 4 seventh, which he doesn't miss fairways. And, you know, to kind of put things into perspective for Scottie Scheffler, before the bogey today on 5, he had gone 22 consecutive holes without a bogey, okay, in this year's tournament. And remember what he did here during the Players. I no longer have those numbers in front of me, but it was ridiculous when you look at him as far as fairways hit, greens in regulation. And remember at Arnold Palmer's tournament the week before the Players over at Bay Hill, I think it was on a Thursday round where he had 9 consecutive one putts, and he didn't miss all round 15 feet or closer. And that's always been, I don't think it's fair for me to say the demon of Scottie Scheffler, but it's been the one issue that you can point to. If you go in tee to green, I don't think there's anyone alive right now that's not going to pick Scottie Scheffler. But if you're talking about making putts, then there's an opportunity to perhaps go with a Bryson DeChambeau, who is a better putter. Max Homa, a little bit younger. You know, Max Homa's never had success at Augusta. Bryson DeChambeau's never had success at Augusta. He's been there 8 times. He's missed the last 2 cuts. His best score ever, Bryson DeChambeau, was 9 years ago when he was an amateur. Okay, so what he's done in consecutive days is almost not unthinkable, but certainly out of the ordinary, at least the first couple of rounds in. So, JJ, Scottie Scheffler just gave one back as well on 13. He parred on 14. Is Scottie Scheffler human, or is he perhaps a little bit concerned about his mama, who's ready to have their first baby?
His wife. I actually think he's playing pretty good for you know, what's happening around him. I mean, he's still par for the day. He's on a par 5 right now. He just laid up, so he's about to take his third shot. I see what you're saying. Putting-wise, that's never been the best part of his game, and he's gotten so good at it, it sort of became a strength recently. But, a couple missed putts here and there. But for me, he's holding it together in a round when everyone else is falling down around him. And if he can get into Saturday with a tie for the lead, I mean, he's got to feel great.
I am officially out of it. Let's see, Cameron Smith just had a bogey, so he goes from 200 to 1 under. So you had Scheffler, okay, and I did not. I took Koepka, Matsuyama, and Smith, so I'm way out of this thing. But I got to say right now, and I'll get your opinion, if you're telling me that this event with 36 holes to play, and for Scheffler it's a few more, is going to come down to Scheffler, DeChambeau, or Homa, we're not even thinking about it.
Oh, it's Scheffler.
I'm going to take Scottie Scheffler over the weekend.
Absolutely. I said it yesterday. I think Bryson's good enough to stick around. But, I mean, we saw today. He's just not consistent enough to beat Scottie Scheffler. Nobody really is right now. Because he was killing it yesterday. Like, long putts. Which, by the way, I said yesterday that we hadn't been able to watch like any of Bryson's round because of the TV coverage. Well, thank you, Masters, for putting every single shot of his on YouTube so I could watch it last night. So he was drilling like long putts. Today, complete opposite. His putter definitely let him down. But he was still in there. You know, he still had birdie putts. He still had pretty decent par putts. So I expect DeChambeau to still hang around until Sunday. But no, I'm taking Scheffler over him. And Max Homa, I mean, he had a great day today. He was in Tiger's group, so we saw basically all of his shots. But he's terrible in majors. I don't think that he has it in him to last until Sunday and compete with Scotty. But we'll see.
Scotty Scheffler's actually down into the teens in driving accuracy at 85.7. The best overall, Siwoo Kim, at 92.9. As far as greens in regulation, which has always been where Scotty Scheffler is at his very best. Again, he's in the teens, 72.2 right now, Scotty Scheffler. And Bryson DeChambeau, 83.3. I read this yesterday. Let me give you this before we bounce out of here. I got to get caught up on a break. I was incredibly long-winded and very excited, kind of like Warren Zevon, the excitable boy, as we began things here on this Friday edition. But when you look at where you at, come on. Listen to this. Listen to this. What do you say, data or data?
I think I say both. But I like more data.
Yeah.
Or
which
maybe
more
I'm
hip?
A data guy.
Which more hip?
I don't think I've ever said it out loud. I think data is more hip.
All right, because around here it's about taking a route. You know, where I'm from, it's a route.
Yeah, I've never said route.
Yeah, so you take route 2 by the Concord Prison, and you just keep barreling on down the road, and before you know it, you'll be smack dab in the middle of Boston.
But you don't say Route 66, though. Like, when you're talking about the specific road, I think everyone says route, but go ahead.
When you get to California, you got to say, yeah, you take the 66. You gotta,
oh.
You got to put the in, okay? I tell you what else I've heard a lot of this week. It's amateur. I keep hearing amateur. It's amateur, right?
Not for golf.
Amateur. I don't like it.
Another one is debutante, which, we know what that is, but I feel like you don't hear that in golf a lot.
I don't know what that is. What is it?
Like, a guy who's making his debut, like our boy Højgaard, this is his first, he's a debutante in the Masters.
I thought debutante was ladies only. Is it the Joan Jett song, Dreamin', or is that Pat Benatar, Dreamin'?
Debutante is especially a young woman making her formal entrance into society.
Right. I've never heard that on the golf course. I'll tell you what else I don't agree with. Sophomore. To me, you got to say he is a sophomore out of Baton Rouge. You got to throw the O in. He is a anyway. Data or data? I'm going to go with data here. Listen to this for Bryson DeChambeau. His first 24 rounds at Augusta, he averaged 3.9 bogeys or worse a round, okay? Hit 61% of the greens, and his strokes gained putting per round was minus 0.48. Yesterday, he went from 3.9 bogeys to 1 bogey. He went from 61% greens hit to 83% greens hit. And his strokes gained putting went from minus 0.48 to plus 3.56. What he did on Thursday was spectacular. But he stuck around today. He did. He plus one. He let one get away, especially on 18. As a matter of fact, his last two non-pars were bogeys on 14 and 18, but still in really good shape as we get set for the weekend. Tonight's show brought to you by Patriot Roofing Services, specializing in all types of commercial, residential roofing and repairs, gutters, sun tubes, skylights, 10-year workmanship warranty. Give my buddy Mark Tozzolo a call at 982-4052, or better yet, check him out online. If you need a new roof or your current roof needs repairs, whether it's your home or business, go to Patriot Roofing Services.
Get Florida Gators play-by-play baseball on 1010XL.
The 24th-ranked Gators scuffle with South Carolina in the Swamp. Friday night, Saturday, and Sunday afternoon on 1010 AM.
There are trucks, and then there's the truck, the GMC Sierra. Frank Franzi here, with available features like the V8 engine, the ultimate luxury interior, and of course, the available world's first six-function multi-pro tailgate. Nimnik Buick GMC has the largest inventory of GMC Sierras in the area. This month, save up to $10,000 off new GMC Sierra 1500 or enjoy rates as low as 1.9% APR financing.
You get it at Nimnik. GMC, we are professional grade.
Blue for Shinatry Chiropractic. They've helped me get rid of my headaches and pain in my neck and back. Are you suffering from an auto accident? What about TMJ pain? Headaches associated with jaw clenching, grinding of the teeth, or stress-related disorders? Shinatry Chiropractic has a physical therapist on staff for rehabilitation, quality chiropractic care, dry needling, massage, and acupuncture. Call 743-6700 or go to shinatrydc.com.
Are you suffering from shoulder pain? If you have clicking and popping in the shoulder joint, persistent pain that intensifies with use, an inability to lift your arm over your head, or a tingling, burning sensation in the shoulder, elbow, or wrist, waiting to see a doctor could make your injury worse. Baptist Health and Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute have innovative and effective treatment options available right now to relieve your pain and restore your mobility. Don't wait. Call 904-JOI-2000.
Hey Jacksonville, I'm sure by now you've seen our bright green GFL trucks and containers throughout the greater Jacksonville area. We are an industry leader in solid waste and would love the opportunity to earn your business. We are committed to customer service, reliability, and have unwavering focus on safety. Whether commercial or construction, let us haul your waste away. Call 904-760-5880 to get a quote today. GFL, green for life.
Hey, Glenn here with B&B Oil. Do you have equipment that needs fuel? We can service any size event from a small wedding with a generator in a tight spot to large construction sites with multiple pieces of large equipment. We deliver all types of fuel and lubricants. We also have fuel tanks from 200 gallons to 2,000 gallons. And we can get larger if needed. So give us a call today or find us online at bb-oil.com. bb-oil.com.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 12, 1953, Ben Hogan shatters the U.S. Masters Tournament record by scoring a 274 while also securing his second Masters win. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, presented by FIS, is home this weekend at 1-1 Financial Ballpark. Tonight is Red Shirt Friday with post-game fireworks presented by Big D Building Center. Tomorrow, the first 2,000 fans get free Jumbo Shrimp pajama pants, plus more fireworks presented by ViStar and First Watch. Then is Baptist Health Sunday Family Fun Day. Log on to jackshrimp.com for tickets. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball. Affordable. Family. Fun.
Have you tried golfing at the Improved Cimarron Golf Club? If you haven't, tell you what, you're missing out on the best deal in Jacksonville. Now, many of you have received a postcard in the mail, and of course, if you bring that with you, $45 plus tax to play. That includes a cart, lunch, and a beer at the brand new Stone Barrel Tap House. Now, go to the website, that is CimarronGolfClub.com, and sign up for the Wild One Loyalty Program. That's the Wild One Loyalty Program, and get all of these specials emailed to you from Cimarron.
Your cooling system isn't working. Maybe somebody showed up with a portable electronic device. Then they discussed with you what your options are. Maybe they gave you an estimate that seems like an awful lot of money. What's the smart thing to do? When the situation merits a second opinion, get a Mike Merritt opinion. Yes, the Mike Merritt Comfort Team shows up with hand tools. We've never been able to fix an air conditioning problem with a tablet. Mike Merritt has been the trusted name for more than 30 years because there's never any hocus pocus. The Merritt team will walk you through the diagnostic steps up close and personal and show you exactly what you need. And the Mike Merritt price is likely to be far less because there's never an overtime charge, and the Merritt team doesn't work on commission. So remember, when it comes to the health of your cooling system, a second opinion can only help, and a Mike Merritt opinion can save you money. Florida license CACO 50384.
Winter time at the Blue Crab Crab House. You know what that means. Time for oysters. Buy them by the tray, broiled, half shell with Romano cheese, wine topping, or fried. And of course, each and every Wednesday, $1 oysters at the Blue Crab Crab House. Serving Northeast Florida since 1996. Make reservations by calling 260-CRAB, Jacksonville's best, the Blue Crab Crab House, off of San Jose on Jewington Creek Road.
There are three certainties in life: death, taxes, and if you stay in your home long enough, a new roof. Pick it here for our friends at Lockhart Roofing. Nobody better in Jacksonville. How do I know? They are a local certified Master Elite contractor, and that means they have a GAF Master Elite warranty. That's the best in the roofing industry. In this day and age, don't settle for cheaper discount roofers. Lockhart Roofing has been here for decades. They aren't going anywhere. Call my friends at Lockhart Roofing, 994-3851. That's 994-3851. Lockhart Roofing, Jacksonville's best for Jacksonville people.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Into the Night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
This will be it for Vern Lundquist, his 40th Masters. He's 83 years of age. Such a huge fan. I mean, I think he's one of those where less is more. And of course, those historic calls, Jack in 86, you know, it is maybe, and then Tiger in 05. But so many great calls for Vern Lundquist. It's tough to believe that his final year at CBS in college football was 2016. And that just blows me away. It tells you how fast time has passed. If you'd put me on the spot, I would have said like 3 years ago. But it was 2016. And I thought he was forced out. I hated it. You know, he makes mistakes, but just the legendary voice. It's going to be it for him. You know, he's been lucky enough to be in his perch, the par 3 16th, all those historic calls there. But this is an end of an icon, in my opinion. I was really bummed when it was the end of the road for Brent Musburger in college football, even though I was told growing up that you're not supposed to like Brent Musburger because when he was calling those games way back when on, I believe it was CBS, that everyone in Boston thought Musburger was leaning towards the Los Angeles Lakers. I think that's great broadcasting if you can get both fan bases to think that you're rooting for the other team. I mean, that's about as outstanding as you can possibly get. But anyway, Vern Lundquist, what a career. 40 years there at the Masters. I said Joan Jett or Pat Benatar. It's actually Blondie that sang the song Dreamin', talking about the debutantes. And I told you about that series that I watched a few years ago, the James Franco one, when he played a couple of different characters. It was like based on the old Times Square back when it was the red light district. And it was actually pretty entertaining. I've got a lot of stuff here on how to effectively and correctly pronounce data. Okay, whether it's data or data. I don't know.
What's the consensus?
You got to watch it on YouTube. So I don't know how we can pull that off here while we're on the radio. Maybe you, this is, it's the 92.47. If you want to pull it up, hope there's no foul language there.
Speechmodification.com, and this is my smart American accent training. In this video,
get to it.
How to pronounce the word data?
Thank you.
Data.
Oh.
And
get to it, lady.
Oh my goodness, this is like 19 questions before LeBron's decision.
The U.S. is we don't make a clear aspirated T sound t in this word. We don't say data.
She just slapped her backside there.
We instead use what's called the flap T, which is where we lift up and lightly touch.
Wow,
come on, lady, we gotta give a master's update.
3 minute answer.
Okay, so thank you for the request. For that word.
Oh my God.
Tell us where you're from. Are you single or are
show
you,
us
or you
that,
have an unhappy husband somewhere?
It sounds like she's saying data.
The data.
Oh my God.
These data show us that.
Oh, she's a real tease.
Oh, so she's saying that there's different times to say it? Oh my God.
What a tease, man. What a tease.
Mrs. Dunbar.
Is it mature or mature?
There's two acceptable ways, she says. So, tomato, well, tomato, which I've always hated that because no
is.
One says tomato.
Of course there is today. We don't want to offend anyone,
yeah, any,
right?
Any data sayers.
Blue was canceled. What for? Well, he called data data. Or he called data data. Yeah. I don't know. Let's get us ready for our second hour. I got to get caught up on breaks. Again, I was really long-winded earlier in the program. Scottie Scheffler is your on-course leader at minus 6 through 15 in the clubhouse. Bryson DeChambeau at 6-under. Max Homa at 6-under.
Now, a Masters update on 1010XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. It's a day of high winds, very few low scores, and a whole lot of grimacing from the best in the world. Bryson DeChambeau has a share of the lead at 6-under. He told SiriusXM he had to adapt.
I'm usually a pretty aggressive individual, but considering the course conditions and the wind conditions that's been out here the past couple of days, I knew I had to be ultra patient. I had to just go inside my own little bubble and not worry about anything else, but just executing each shot the best I possibly can.
DeChambeau with a 1 over 73 today. That could have been a whole lot worse. DeChambeau became a meme at 13. He picked up an Augusta National signpost to be able to play his ball. Too bad Easter was 2 weeks ago. DeChambeau actually made birdie there. It's Bryson, Scottie Scheffler, and Max Homa leading the way at 6-under. Homa in the clubhouse like DeChambeau. Scheffler has 4 holes to go today. He's even through 14. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
Now your ideas don't have to wait. Now they have everything they need to come to life. Dell Technologies and Intel are creating technology that loves ideas. Loves expanding your business, evolving your passions. We push what technology can do, so great ideas can happen right now. Find out how to bring your ideas to life at Dell.com. Welcome to now.
Shop our best savings for spring during Spring Fest at Lowe's. Right now, get a free leaf blower and select combo kits. And stock up on soil for all your gardening projects. Get 3 bags of 3/4 cubic foot Miracle-Gro garden soil free when you buy 3. Because Lowe's knows home improvement. Offers valid through 4/17. Compared to trimmer purchased separately. Blower and trimmer sold packaged together as combo kit. Includes 1 battery and charger. Miracle-Gro offer excludes Alaska and Hawaii. While supplies last.
Dustin Johnson, Jordan Spieth, Brian Harman, Justin Rose, Sergio Garcia, Bubba Watson, just a few of the major champions who will miss the cut here at Augusta National. And with all of those struggles, Tiger Woods' accomplishment looks that much more impressive. With an even par 72 here in the second round, he'll make the cut for a Masters record 24th consecutive time. Woods at +1 overall, 7 off the lead. We check the leaderboard, sponsored by Dell. Dell Technologies pushes what technology can do, so your great ideas can happen right now. Learn more at Dell.com. Max Homa, Bryson DeChambeau, Scottie Scheffler, 6-under. Nikolai Højgaard, 2 back at 4-under. Defending champion Jon Rahm riding the cut line with a birdie at 15. He's at +5. Ricky Fowler on the wrong side of the cut line at +6 with 1 hole to go. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emmerich, Westwood One Sports.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory. Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
Crosser here. When it comes to the business of selling your home, there's one promise I can give you that will deliver, and that promise is ChadAndSandy.com. That's Chad, A-N-D, Sandy.com. How do I know this promise is guaranteed? Because they say so, and then they deliver. You see, Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. So whatever problems you think you're having selling your home, there is your simple solution. They're going to buy it if it's not sold for exactly what you want. Mortgage rates have lowered going into the spring selling season. Now is the time to maximize your equity, and you can do it with the real estate team of Chad and Sandy. They have a plan and the experience to sell your home fast for maximum cash this spring. John and Ursula in Green Meadows wrote in, we weren't in great health, decided to downsize to an easier place to manage. After 185 days, our home failed to sell. We went to Chad and Sandy, sold in 12 days. You can too at ChadAndSandy.com.
PRP treatment is kind of the thing these days, and in many cases, it eliminates the need for surgery.
This is Sheridan Tootin, and my experience with PRP from Southeast Orthopedic Specialist has been nothing short of great. I'm really feeling much better now. Ask your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist doctor about PRP treatment.
This is Dr. Kevin Murphy with Southeast Orthopedic Specialist, where athletes are treated like pros.
Relieve pain and get back to life. Southeast Orthopedic Specialist.
The flagship station of the Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
AgPro Sign and Drive Event is offering 0% for 84 months with no money down on a John Deere compact utility tractor with loader. Limited time offer. Visit your local AgPro dealer today. Offer ends April 30th, 2024. Subject to approved credit. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Are you 18 years or older? Just got married? Just got divorced or have children? Listen up. Have you done your last will and estate planning? If you have questions, call Matt Hinson with the Hinson Law Firm. Reach him at 527-1700. Office is Jacksonville, Florida. And don't let the state decide your fate.
Spilled your drink? Quick, the quicker picker-upper. Bounty picks up spills quicker. And each sheet is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less than the leading ordinary brand. So, you can get back to your night. Bounty, the quicker picker-upper.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's challenger, a corporate management manager from Jacksonville, Florida. Meet Les Blankston.
Yeah, hi, Bob.
That is a remarkably beige suit there, Les. Tell us, why are you on the show?
Well, I just replaced my old air conditioner with a new one from Bueller, and I'm just so comfortable these days. I wondered, am I cool now?
Let's find out, Les. Go ahead and spin the wheel.
That's right, Les. By upgrading your old AC to a more energy-efficient model from Bueller Air Conditioning, you'll save money, save energy, and proudly show your family that
you are cool.
Do you think I should get a mohawk?
Pace yourself, Les.
Stay cooler with Bueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
I can't believe tax season is here already.
But look at all this info I have to enter.
Phil's small accounting firm is growing in numbers.
Why didn't I take that typing class in high school?
A data entry specialist could really help him in a crunch.
I got blisters on my fingers.
Indeed can help him hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. You can schedule and conduct virtual interviews all from your employer dashboard. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
All right, Scotty Scheffler through 16, so he's got a couple of holes to go. He's your on-course leader at 6-under. Of course, a few have been in the clubhouse. Max Homa for quite some time, played with Tiger and Jason Day earlier. Today, they had to play 23 holes. Bryson DeChambeau as well wrapped up about an hour or so ago. He is at 6-under. So, Homa and DeChambeau at -6. Scotty Scheffler at 6-under par as well. Let's get you caught up in the very latest. Let's bring in my buddy Rick Shoemaker, of course, is the owner and operator over at Cimarron. Cimarron Golf, located right there on 210. Rick, good to have you back.
No, happy to be here. Happy to be here talking to you about most famous tournament in the world.
Yeah, and one of the ugliest days that we've seen as far as Mother Nature. We've had winds today up to 40 miles per hour.
It's absolutely crazy. But again, I always say, and I've said this to you on the show, when you look at these guys and what they can perform and how they perform, it's amazing. You know, I was just looking at some stats here of some of the players, and Tiger Woods, he draws the crowds, and you know, I hate to say this, I'm not a fan of Tiger, but I probably found myself, Rick, 3 or 4 times today picking up my phone and seeing how Tiger was doing.
Yeah, whether it's course recognition, pin placements, all the nuances that go into knowledge of a course, that comes with experience. But Rick, how can you prepare for the wind the way it's been today?
you know, again, those guys, their swings are so good. They understand how to control it and, you know, take that extra club, swing a little easier and keep the ball lower. They're power players in this day and age, but these guys are the best in the world. And these top 20, 30 guys are learning to, you know, have learned to play in this type of condition, and you're seeing it.
Yeah.
And then again, there's the old adage of Texas guys and the Texas boys. Scheffler's one of them. Certainly know how to play in it.
Mm-hmm. Bryson DeChambeau, we touched upon yesterday. It was nearly a flawless round. I wasn't aware of the fact when we did talk a day ago that, you know, his eight times there, his highest ever or his best ever round was when he was an amateur. And his last 2 years, he's missed the cut. So I know things like this do happen on the PGA Tour. In this case, obviously, he's a member of the LIV Tour. But, you know, what he's done through 36 holes is nothing short of just incredible.
No, it is. And again, look, they look at his iron play. That's a big deal. Again, Golf Channel talked about that last night, and those new irons he put in his bag, you know, they're improving his greens in regulation. I mean, I think today, looking at the stats, he's number, I guess, top six, mm-hmm. at 83%. I mean, if you drive it 322 yards, which was his average, and he's only, you know, second in the field, and you hit 83% of the greens, You're going to go low.
I'm glad you mentioned his irons, because he wasn't, you know, officially cleared by the USGA until Monday. But, you know, apparently it's a I believe you pronounce it a VODA. And they're, you know, made from a 3D. They made from 3D printing. And when you're that wealthy and you have all of these big time companies coming after you saying, please use my brand, please use our clubs. I know he's got that mad scientist reputation, but are you surprised he went so against the norm to do something like this as far as his clubs?
I would tell you, if you were talking about, hey, there's a PGA Tour player and you didn't say their name, mm-hmm. I'd say, yeah, I'm incredibly surprised. But once you hear Bryson DeChambeau, you're not surprised. Everything he did since he stepped on the course has been unique, and you know, he's driving his own train, and he's gonna do it his way.
Yeah.
And it's working for him. It's always worked for him, and again, that's why he's having such success right now.
Scottie Scheffler has a hole and a half to play. Right now he's tied with both DeChambeau and Homa at 600. I think the betting public, it's not even a question who you're gonna pick to finish here the final 36 holes. Scottie Scheffler's your answer, but he has looked a little human today. Missed about a 2.5, 3, 3.5 foot putt on 5, and then it felt as though maybe he was a little bit rattled on the par 3 after, followed up by going way right on the 7th hole as well. What have you made of Scottie Scheffler's round?
Look, I think the only thing I would say is that putting, those issues he's had, and that's what's rearing its head a little bit. He's been on this run, and he has not had those issues. And that's the only thing that's ever going to keep him from going on one of these Tiger runs or winning 8 or 9 in a row.
Mm-hmm.
But I think he's going to get through it. He's a competitor. He's a grinder. And I'll be shocked if he's not in the top 4 names coming down the back 9 on Sunday. I don't see anything that's pointing to that otherwise.
Rick Shoemaker, our guest. He is the owner and operator over at Cimarron Golf. You can go to their website. When you do, make sure you check out the Loyalty Club program by going to CimarronGolf.com. He joins Rick Ballew. Again, 3 golfers right now at 6 under par, leading the way through the second round of the Masters. All right, let's spend a minute on Tiger Woods here. And, you know, yesterday he was making his way through Amen Corner, and then obviously the sum went down. So he gets up today. He's minus 1 through 13, immediately bogeys 14, pars 15, 16, 17, bogeys 18 again to go plus 173. And then it's just like a Phil Mickelson card to get things started for his, you know, his first official 9 holes on this Friday, Rick. It's 3 birdies, 3 bogeys, and 3 pars for Tiger Woods.
Yeah, again, you know, it's the flat stick. He's hitting the ball today. Again, his staff, he's in the top 5 or 10 in accuracy off the tee, which is abnormal for him. And then greens in regulation, it's just always going to be about the flat stick. And I think, again, the stats show he's in the bottom 10 today mm-hmm. in putting.
Yeah.
That's how good he hit it, but he did not, finish that off with the flat stick.
Yeah. And
but he, you can't discount the guy.
Right.
I mean, again, I'm not a fan, but my gosh, look, he's missed every cut with Drew in the past 2 years, virtually, you know, except for one event, I think. And here he is making a cut, and he's a T21. Amazing.
Yeah, you look at those numbers, and again, you're spot on with it, but watching every hole, my goodness, he made a lot of cuts. He made a lot of putts 10 feet and closer where he was really scrambling. I mean, really grinding just to save par. And if, you know, he missed those putts, he wouldn't be around for the weekend.
No. And, again, that's why, you know, he is who he is. The grinding, the ability to overcome those things and make it happen.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm surprised with you know, we'll talk about another guy, Rory. I'm very surprised to see Rory. I think he's got, what, two holes left, and he's right at that cut line, I think.
Yeah.
Just shocking to me, to be honest with you.
Well, some of the best on the planet, whether it's Rory at +4, John Rahm, he just had a long birdie putt on 17. But, boy, he's really struggled today. And, you know, even traditionally, some of the great golfers. I mean, look at Dustin Johnson, Rick, a birdie machine, +13. He had one birdie on 36 holes, and obviously he's already left. He's not going to be around for the weekend.
No, I'm looking at that. I think it's Justin Thomas, Tony Finau, and Rahm all at +5.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, Finau's in the clubhouse, but Rahm and Thomas are playing the last hole.
Yeah.
On par to make the cut. But how about those old guys? How about Phil Mickelson?
Oh, yeah.
And I think Vijay Singh made the cut.
Yeah. Hey, as we say goodbye, and I'm not going to assume anything, but I would guess that you would pick Scheffler to hang on here through the weekend. If not, tell me who else. But can you make a point, whether it's Colin Morikawa or Cameron Davis, can you make a point for anyone else not named Scheffler, DeChambeau, or Homa to make a serious run tomorrow during moving day and to possibly win it on Sunday?
You know, who I'm looking at is Cameron Smith.
Really?
He's out on that LIV tour. He's mm-hmm. at one under.
Yep.
He's got three holes to go. If he can get in at one under or two under with his putting stroke, again, we don't get to see these guys as much, right?
Nah, it's
but
unfortunate.
I've been interested to see him just kind of hanging out, and there he is, sitting in the top 10. I think that's a little bit of a dark horse.
He's got three holes to go. You're spot on. Yes, 16, 17, and 18 for Cameron Smith right now presently at one under. He's tied for eighth, five strokes behind the three leaders at -6. Rick Shoemaker with Cimarron Golf. All right, I know you got live entertainment getting set to kick off right now over at Cimarron. Tell us what's going on.
No, we got live entertainment. It's Friday night. People enjoying the outdoor patio. I mean, look at this weather we've got. We've got some incredible weather coming up through the weekend. Golf is going to be busy. It's going to be fun. I mean, in fact, by the way, Augusta is going to be 86 on Sunday, but here we are in St. Augustine, Florida, Jacksonville at 76. So we better get out there, play some golf, and just enjoy this life right now before summer hits us in the face come May.
No doubt about it. Hey, tell our listeners to get to the website, Cimarron Golf. .com, and of course to sign up as well for the Loyalty Club program.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, just leave your email. You'll be part of the Loyalty Club, the Wild One. You'll get the deals weekly. Might be as simple as $5 or $10 off, but it might be our all-inclusive package that we still do once or twice a week. It's $45, includes golf and beer. We send that out in the email. It's on the slower days, and we just love to have people out here enjoying the game and just enjoying what life's about, which is the outdoors and the sunshine of Florida.
Well, I'm going to sneak away and go visit my dad and my brother this weekend in Tampa, but I'm looking forward to playing golf out there on Tuesday. Always a blast at Cimarron. Rick Shoemaker, always a lot of fun. Thank you.
Hey, thank you.
There he goes. Good stuff there. Very latest. And if you haven't played Cimarron, that's on you. Right. Wonderful changes that they've made over there. And they've really poured a lot of money into it. They've done tremendous work on the greens, okay, the fairways, the tee boxes, and how about the brand-new clubhouse, both indoors and outdoors? Just a tremendous facility right there on 210. Okay, so go ahead and check it out. Let me know what you think when you get an opportunity to play it. The best bet is to always just get me on the text line at 641-1010. Brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures, or you can get me on Twitter, Baloo1010XL. All right, let's. Did anything happen while Rick and Rick were having a conversation?
Yeah. So Rom hit that long birdie putt on 15.
Yep.
And then he gave one right back. So he's at five over, teeing off on 18. He has to par to make the cut, and up to the leaders. So Scottie Scheffler has a long two putt to make par on 17. He's right at the front of the green. I believe he'll be able to do it. And that would take him. That would make him tied going into 18. So we're getting right down to the end right here.
Look at this card for John Rahm coming in: a double bogey on 14, a birdie on 15, a birdie on 16, a bogey on 17. Tony Finau posted a 78 today, but apparently he's going to be around at plus five. Look at the scores: Chris Kirk 75 plus five, going to be around. JT posted a 74 plus five, going to stick around. Camilla Viljagas, what a great comeback story that is. A 75 plus 5, he's going to be around. Justin Thomas has a hole to play, as we just discussed. Some others who are going home. Ricky Fowler, plus 6. 76, 74, he's going to miss it by a stroke. Adam Scott's going to miss it by a stroke, plus 6. So, really impressive. Vijay Singh.
Love that.
Wow. 73 today, plus 4. Going to grab himself a paycheck. North of 50, as we do know. One amateur is going to make it. Neil Shipley. Okay, a 76 today, a 71 yesterday, plus 3. So he is the only amateur that is going to be around for the weekend. Good news there. We got much more to do with you tonight up until 8 o'clock.
Now, a Masters update on 1010XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. It has been one of the toughest days ever at Augusta. That's a product of 40-mile-per-hour gusts and baked greens. Now less than an hour to sunset, the wind has dialed back just a little bit, only 30. Mile-per-hour gusts. Scottie Scheffler with three straight pars since a bogey at 13 that featured his second shot caroming into the tributary of Rays Creek. Scheffler tied for the lead at 6-under with Max Homa and Bryson DeChambeau. Homa and DeChambeau in the clubhouse. Homa with a 1-under 71 today. DeChambeau a 1-over 73. He had it to 8-under at one point before bogeys at two of his last five holes. Tiger Woods' body held up today through 23 holes with the end of his first round and all of his second round, and Tiger's reward is two more rounds here. Woods grinding to an even par 72. He's plus one overall, seven back. So Tiger breaks the Masters record with his 24th consecutive made cut. He shared the mark with Gary Player and Fred Couples. Woods has deflected any questions about that because he still thinks he can win. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
Around here at Wrangler, we are all excited for spring. The longer days, the warmer nights. When you've got your pick of shorts and jeans, either works just fine. Blue skies, open roads. Wrangler, for the ride of life.
Every business faces challenges, but complicated, expensive, and uncertain shipping shouldn't be one of them.
With USPS Ground Advantage from the United States Postal Service, you can avoid all the noise.
No more unexpected surcharges, hidden fees, or complex rate structures.
It's just easy, cost-effective, and dependable shipping. Tune your business's frequency to success and turn shipping to your advantage. Learn how at usps.com/advantage. USPS Ground Advantage. Simple, affordable, reliable.
Around here at Wrangler, we are all excited for spring. The longer days, the warmer nights. When you've got your pick of shorts and jeans, either works just fine. Blue skies, open roads. Wrangler, for the ride of life.
Ludvig Åberg might be the next great young star in golf. The Swede who starred at Texas Tech posting the round of the day, a 3-under 69. Åberg now 2-under, that's 4 off the lead. He had 6 birdies on a day where birdies have been scarce. Let's check the leaderboard. Sponsored by Wrangler Jeans. It's Wrangler season out there. Open roads, endless horizons. Shop Wrangler.com for new denim styles. It's Homa, DeChambeau, and Scheffler atop at 6-under. Nikolai Højgaard 2 back at 4-under. Cameron Davis and Colin Morikawa 3-under, 3 back. Don't forget about Morikawa, the former PGA and British Open champ at 2-under 70 today for Morikawa. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emmerich, Westwood One Sports.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory. Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
Hey, it's Tony from Tony D's Pizza. If you love our pizza and pasta dishes, let us cater an event for you. Family function or office parties, we can deliver you an amazing Italian meal. Remember, it's not just pizza at Tony D's. Bay Meadows and 295.
There are only a few things the government does well, and processing passports is not one of them. Hello, it's Congressman Aaron Bean, and taking care of constituents in Northeast Florida is a top priority. If you need help with that passport, the VA, Social Security, or any federal agency, call my office, 904-557-9550, or visit bean.house.gov. I'm Congressman Aaron Bean, and serving you is what we do. Paid for by official funds authorized by the House of Representatives.
Bring your guns and bring your hoses, and we're ready to put up some punches. It's Guns and Hoses Charity Boxing. It's back. It's that time. Bell time. In fact, 6:30, Saturday, April 20th. Join us at UNF Arena. Dan and I there for the millionth year in a row. It is so much fun, this charity boxing, and it's serious, and it's fun, and it's impactful, and you're going to have a great time. By the way, street party before and after the event. Make it a day. Saturday, April 20th. Bell time, 6:30, UNF Arena. Guns and Hoses.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 12, 1953, Ben Hogan shatters the U.S. Masters Tournament record by scoring a 274 while also securing his second Masters win.
Joe C. for CSS Fireplaces and Outdoor Living. They can transform your backyard with fire pits, pergolas, screen enclosures, and outdoor kitchens. And CSS handles the entire project from start to finish. You dream it, they build it. CSSOutdoor.com.
Beards Diamond's most popular sale is back.
All wedding bands are buy one, get one free.
Plus, all stackables, all right hand rings, all eternity bands, and more are buy one, get one free.
At the St. John's Town Center or at BeardsDiamonds.com.
Have you or someone you care about been arrested or had their driver's license taken away? I'm Susan Cohen, and I work with David Robbins at the law firm of Epstein & Robbins. We are experienced fighters for those charged with DUI and all criminal offenses. I've been named the best DUI attorney in the state, and David has been named the best criminal defense lawyer in Jacksonville. In your battle with the justice system, there is only one thing you need to know. Dial David 24/7 at Epstein & Robbins, 354-5600. 45.
All right, guys, be a true grill master with the Sausage Dudes sausage and upgrade that cookout. The Sausage Dudes are guys from Jacksonville who use their family recipes to make better sausage with the best cuts of pork, carefully sourced spices, and natural casings. And the Sausage Dudes are mission-minded, supporting the Boys and Girls Club of Northeast Florida. Try all four flavors because your cookout deserves better. Now available at all Publix stores in the frozen meat section. Head to Publix today and get your hands on the Sausage Dude sausage.
Hey, sports fans, it's Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. Oh, it is here. Masters Week, my favorite Tigers in the field. We've got the LIV Golf guys playing in a major again. It is going to be a blast. If you haven't signed up for MyBookie, you need to sign up. This is going to be must-see TV, and you can bet long odds for big golf sweats and even bigger cash. Outright winners, first round leaders, and live betting too. I'm telling you, if you haven't signed up yet for MyBookie, do it now for Masters Week. Could the weather in Augusta cause some chaos? Take advantage of that. Make some money. Even if the Masters has started, you can live bet with long odds through Sunday afternoon. Getting started is simple. Sign up today at MyBookie and use promo code 1010XL to secure a first deposit bonus up to 50%. It's simple. Just use promo code 1010XL to claim your 50% bonus, $50 minimum. Bet anything, anytime, anywhere with MyBookie.
Staying active no matter what your age is key to living life at its fullest. And Rebound Rehabilitation wants you to know they can get you back up to speed and back in the game pain-free. Rebound Rehabilitation, with 8 locations across the First Coast, top-of-the-line therapist ready to assist you. From neck and back pain, knee or foot pain, they can help. Excellent patient care combined with the highest quality and rehabilitation services. Look for a Rebound Rehab location near you and get back in the game. Log on, reboundrehab.com.
This is Hayes Carline for SkyLife Elite. Are you tired of canceled flights, unruly passengers, and layovers? Call my friends at SkyLife Elite. Consider using private charter flights for your next adventure. Yes, you can afford it. Make your own schedule. Fly direct. Drive your car to Craig Airport and get directly on the plane. SkyLife Elite can make that happen. Call 490-9332, go to flyskylife.com, and find them on social media. Fly SkyLife Elite, North Florida's premier private air charter.
It doesn't get any better than live country music. Enjoy Daryl Ray at Players Grill Miramar this Friday at 7 p.m. with discount cocktails while the local star rocks out. Players Grill Miramar, where the neighborhood meets.
This is my bar.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Into the Night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
There it is. Probably my favorite Blondie tune. Here comes the debutante. Ready?
You could tell I was no debutante.
In this case, she wasn't a debutante. Watching these guys come in, there's no offense. As a matter of fact, the offense reminds me of a Nate Hackett, Doug Marrone fourth quarter-led offense.
In an AFC title game.
Against the New England Patriots in Foxborough. I mean, they are just trying. These golfers are literally watching the clock tick, 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 and is trying to get in alive. As I say that, Rory, who's right on the cut line, actually the cut line now has gone to plus six. He is just way right, deep into the forest.
That's going to take a long time to find that one.
I was just having a conversation about the golfers at plus five with Rick Shoemaker. And one of the guys we highlighted was Justin Thomas. JJ, you were involved in this as well. This is what JT did a moment ago coming in. Okay? Double bogey on 15, double bogey on 16, bogey on 17, a double bogey on 18 to post a 79 for a plus 7, even though the projected cut line has gone from plus 5 to plus 6. JT is not going to make the cut at plus 7. Sergio Garcia, same deal. Okay, look at what he came in with. Bogey on 15, bogey on 16, bogey on 17, double bogey on 18.
That actually makes JT's scorecard look pretty bad.
To miss the cut.
Only one bogey instead of three double bogeys in the last four holes for JT. Everyone's walking off 18 like it's a funeral. I haven't seen one person smiling. Not one player today walking off 18 has been able to crack a smile. Maybe just to be like, wow, that was terrible. Like, I have to just laugh at myself. It's carnage. We just saw Hideki. Like, he had to just bogey 18 to get in at 5 over, which we thought the cut line was going to be. Couldn't even do that.
Hey, double bogey.
Double bogey. So he might get saved with the cut line going to 6 over, but it's straight carnage out there. 18 is killing everybody, and guess what? Rahm's on 18. He actually has a putt for birdie, which is rare. But Scheffler's coming into 18 right now, so if Scheffler can par, he would stay tied for the lead, but man, it's going to be tough.
Also going to keep an eye on, well, where do you, Matt Fitzpatrick, who is on 18. He just missed the green.
Pretty far left.
Yeah, pretty far left for him. Still an opportunity to get up and down and get out of there at minus one through 36. So, my goodness, John Rahm nearly rolled that in. He did on 16 from about 50 feet.
And he barely touched it. Like, these greens are so quick today.
Well, just think. I mean, it's the moisture is
how did that not go in?
Completely gone. And with the wind, they've dried out at an incredible rate. So, I mean, 40-mile-an-hour winds. And, again, I talked about it a little bit earlier today. First-round draws, the early draw on Thursday, 72.6 was the average score. Late draw was 74.2, and that included earlier today wrapping up the first round. At the last look I had, it was 75.77. This was around 3 o'clock this afternoon. It's now 7:30, so I got to believe that this has increased to, I'm guessing, over 76. I don't know officially what it is, but you're talking about a 3.5-stroke difference between the early draw on Thursday and today, Friday's entire round, if it is, in fact, over 76. And, heck, it could be 76 and some change, seeing all the bogeys and double bogeys coming in. So
maybe they should have done a shotgun start. Just kidding.
No. Fitz here.
Yeah, this is what I hate about ESPN's coverage of the Masters is Fitzpatrick is in the top 10, has been all day. He's one under. They've shown literally one of his shots.
Mm-hmm.
I hate that. Like, we've seen more of this Dunlap kid's shots than his. It doesn't make sense. I understand he's not like a crazy popular player, but the guy won the U.S. Open. He's not some random.
Nope.
And he's in the top 10.
Dunlap, an amateur who won for the first time in 33 years out of Alabama, is now a pro. Now, did Rory get a kick out of there to give it a Judge Schmale's foot wedge? Because all of a sudden they showed him on the corner of the fairway after what appeared that he went deep into the woods. Again, there was no television coverage on it, so we'll have to see. Just for those of you who are wondering.
No, that's his second shot. So
okay.
Well, I don't know what the hell happened.
He must have gotten a great kick out of the woods. For those that are wondering, 36 out of the last 37 winners of the Masters have been in the top 10 through 36 holes, okay? 92% of the Masters winners all time have been within 5 shots of the lead entering moving day. So that would include those who were tied for 8th at 1 under par. That's Fleetwood, Pavon, Young, on Fox, Willett, and we'll see what happens here with Fitzpatrick. Still with an outside opportunity to get back into this. As Scottie Scheffler with a hole to play at 6 under, Bryson DeChambeau at minus 6, Max Homa at minus 6. Hey, I mentioned the Jaguars. I have good news for you. As expected, Thursday, we are going to get an opportunity to talk with Trent Baalke and Doug Peterson. That is exactly 1 week ahead, or 1 week away from the NFL draft. So that'll be next Thursday. Already excited about that coming up, with the opportunity to get a little something. And I will say that they've really been transparent as of late. You know, getting, whether it's the combine or just whatever it's been, I don't know what to expect coming up on Thursday. We shall see. And Matt Fitzpatrick now with the bogey on 18. So he falls from minus one to even par. So right now, unofficially, there are only 14 golfers in red figures. And as far as I know, only two that are left out on the golf course. That is Scottie Scheffler at minus 6 through 17 and Cameron Smith through 17 holes at minus one. So pretty incredible stuff right there. All right, let's take our final break of the night, come back, put our final touches on this one right here on 1010XL and 92.5 FM. Real quick, game two tonight of Florida State Miami in this baseball series. Florida State a winner last night.
Yeah, you guys just took the lead.
Okay, I saw this. The last 213 baseball games between Florida State and Miami, dating back to 1981, Florida State, 105 wins. Miami, 105 wins, three ties.
That's just like football.
It was during that 80s and 90s and all of that, no doubt, even into the 2000s.
Right now, we lead 35-33 in football, so it's just as neck and neck.
All right, back to baseball. Last 149 games since 1991, 74-74-1.
That's crazy.
Okay, last 125 games since 1995, Florida State-Miami, each with 62 wins and a tie. And after last night's Florida State victory, from 1996 on, the last 115 games, 57-57-1. That is absolutely incredible if you look at it that way, this great rivalry between Florida State and Miami in baseball. Game two underway right now in God's country. We'll give you a score on that on the other side as well.
May I have your attention, please?
Get ready for 1010XL's new primetime lineup. Start the day with Dan Hicken and Jeff Prosser. Dempsey and Fat Tony take you to noon. It's the Ladies of Helmets and Heels until 2. XL Primetime follows at 4. Franchi and Carline drive you home. Then Baloo and Hacker take you into the night.
It's showtime!
Imagine driving a late model Corvette, BMW, Mercedes, Lexus, Honda, Chevy, Ford, and more, all at a fraction of the original sticker price. Visit Vaughn Motor Group's indoor showroom and browse a great selection of dream cars that are inspected with warranties. Before you make your next auto purchase, check out Vaughn Motor Group on San Jose Boulevard or at VaughnMotorGroup.com for a complete inventory listing. If you can dream it, you can drive it at Vaughn Motor Group.
Hello, sports fans. Hicken here. Let's talk skin. Iron Beach's Dermatology are reminding you to wear your sunscreen. If you're an active parent, hanging at the fields, in your boat to fish, or like to chill at the sandbar, wear sunscreen. But if you're the one that decided for years it's not cool, guess what? Cancer isn't cool either. So when grabbing the clubs for your tee time, gassing up the boat, or grabbing the chairs for your kids' games, make sure you bring the screen. Any concerns now? Give Beaches Dermatology a call online at BeachesDermatology.com.
Lauren Brooks here from Mayport C&C Fisheries. Growing up at the beach, I know good shrimp and oysters when I see them. They're local and they're fresh. That's why Mayport C&C Fisheries is my go-to for both. They have local shrimp in stock 7 days a week. Eat like a local at Mayport C&C Fisheries.
Electricians, innovators, and tech enthusiasts, listen up. Miller Electric is shaping the future, and we want you to be a part of it. From healthcare and data centers, corporate offices, aviation, and industrial facilities, Miller Electric is powering the most exciting projects in Jacksonville and beyond. We offer not just a job, but a thrilling career with great pay and incredible benefits. Visit us at MillerCareers.com to apply. Miller Electric, where your skills meet our vision and equal opportunity employer.
A tradition unlike any other.
Rays Creek, Butler Cabin, and the Green Jacket.
Ready to rip it.
The Masters.
That's a beauty.
Masters coverage on 1010XL is brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
Thanks for calling Discover. This is Gabby.
Hey, Gabby. It's Jennifer Coolidge. Hi. I'm so glad I reached you at 2 a.m.
Oh, of course. Anyone with a Discover card can call and talk to a real person 24/7. Now, how can I help?
Yeah, I used my Discover card to buy these yellow pleather pajamas, and I'm just not sure I'm pulling them off.
24/7 U.S.-based customer service. It pays to Discover. Limitations apply. Learn more at discover.com/creditcard.
I've always gotten tons of UTIs. Cranberry products never worked for me, and I was desperate for a way to be proactive. I'm Jenna Ryan, CEO and founder of Eucora. We've worked with doctors to develop effective urinary tract health products. Just mix a packet of Eucora with water and drink it when you need support, like right after intimacy. Eucora is helping over 100,000 women stay healthy. Ready to join them? Get 30% off at eucora.com/radio. That's eucora.com/radio.
Attention all business owners. The raining season is coming, and it's important to ensure that your property storm drains are free from debris and functioning properly. That's where DuckDuck Rooter comes in. Our powerful VACCON truck can effectively clean out your storm drains and prevent costly damage to your property from flooding. Don't let clogged storm drains ruin your business and reputation. Call Duck Duck Rooter today to schedule a cleaning before the rains hit. 904-862-6769 or online at duckduckrooter.com.
Are you embarrassed by your ugly, cracked concrete driveway? Need to enhance your home's curb appeal? StoneCore on Phillips Highway is your one-stop shop for all your outdoor needs. Replacing with new stone pavers will transform your driveway into a stunning work of art. Say goodbye to unsightly concrete and hello to beautiful, durable pavers that last for years. Visit StoneCore today and let's beautify your home together. StoneCore.co. We do outdoors better.
I'm here with Clayton Bromberg of Underwoods. Clayton, let's talk about diamond cutting. How is a diamond price affected by the way it is cut?
Frank, that's probably the most important question asked about diamonds, because the trade-off between a diamond cut for maximum beauty and one that's not is the diamond's carat weight. You see, diamond cutters buy rough diamonds based on quality and weight. So as they cut the rough diamond, everything cut away affects profits. However, there's specific known cutting parameters, and each deviation from these means they have a heavier, less beautiful diamond. Unfortunately, a customer can't detect all those cutting imperfections. They need expert help about a diamond's cut grade. You see, for any round diamond of a particular color, clarity, and carat weight, there are as many as 10 different prices that can vary by as much as 50%. At Underwoods, we look specifically at how a diamond's cut before we look at anything else, because it's the most important factor when it comes to a diamond's beauty, and to us, whether it should carry the Underwood name or not.
Elevate your party game to the next level with Mystic Cornhole Company. Visit their showroom now on the corner of Hogan and Parental Home Road. It's your one-stop destination for all things cornhole. MysticCornhole.com.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle. Unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies candidates with the right skills, sends you great matches, then you can easily invite them to apply. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. See for yourself. Go to ZipRecruiter.com/free to try ZipRecruiter for free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Into the Night with Rick Ballew on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Roy McIlroy, a 77. He has completed his second round. He's at +4. He will be around for the weekend. It looks like the cut is going to be 6 over par. Right now, I have, would it go into +6? There's going to be 60 golfers unofficially that'll be around. Remember, it's +50 in ties, but the scores have gone way, way up. And it's by one, it's by really one golfer, because I'm looking at the top 49, which includes John Rahm after his 76, a defending champion, and Tony Finau, a 78 today. 49 golfers at +5 or better. The way things are, it's +6. It's a top 50 in ties. So at number 50, that includes Jose Maria Olazabal, who won it in, 30 years ago and 25 years ago, respectively. And that's also going to allow some other former champions back in, including Hideki Matsuyama, as we talked about him, and Adam Scott, both at +6. Ricky Fowler. I felt that all of these guys are going to be sent home, but unless something incredible changes here, and I can't see it, you would have to have birdie after birdie after birdie. Scottie Scheffler just missed his birdie putt on 18. He's got about a 4-footer or so to save par here on 18, and he has made it. So for Scottie Scheffler, a 72 even par today for Scheffler. He will join the likes of Max Homa and Bryson DeChambeau, 6 under par, coming up on Saturday.
I wonder how they decide who's in the final group.
First in, first out, right? Or is it? I know it's different for different tournaments. I believe it's...
So what would that mean? Since since DeChambeau finished before Homa, then he would be the second to last group?
I'm under the belief it will be Homa and DeChambeau in the last group. I don't know that for sure.
Okay.
But I would be I'm under the belief that that's the case. If someone knows, please let us know immediately on our text line, 641-1010, brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures. That's why we ask you. I believe that's what it is. But I could be wrong.
For TV purposes, I hope they make it Scheffler versus DeChambeau. But it doesn't really matter. We're going to see all the shots.
Homa's actually got a great personality.
They love, golf media loves them some Homa.
Yeah.
They're begging for him to finally do good at a major.
He's
one of those guys who's really good in all the other tournaments.
Cameron Smith lives in Jacksonville, is out in Pontevedra, and he's now his approach on 18. He's at minus one. It was a very good approach, if it'll stick. And I believe that was his second shot. So I'm under the impression that that is going to be, for birdie, probably, I don't know, 18 feet or so.
That's about as close as we've seen anybody.
Long hair flowing, stash. He's got the Jacksonville look.
Oh, yeah.
Folks, it's been a treat. I love it. I love the Masters. I hope you love it as well. Enjoy it coming up this weekend. Be safe. I'm off to Tampa in the morning. Watch the Masters with my dad and my brother and his family. So it's going to be a heck of a lot of fun. The next time I see you, many of you will be at the Googan coming up Monday over at Hidden Hills. We'll be back on Monday night at 6 o'clock. Thank you to Rick Shoemaker for joining us. Of course, you can get everything from CimarronGolf.com, including the loyalty program, which is just incredible. Email them. For J.J. LaSelva, my name is Rick Ballew. Have a safe weekend. We'll talk Monday at 6.